Welcome back. Here we are back on the Islands of Junaro. I did back here messing around. The reason why I'm having to bring you this little face cam up in the corner here is when we went to shoot the episode, I caught everything. Game sound, his voice, but not mine. For some reason, the software decided that my voice was not important in the video. I really don't know what happened. So what I'm going to do instead, I've sped some parts up that were kind of boring, so you'll see it skip pretty fast at some points in the game. But what I really wanted to do was just kind of bring you up to speed on what we're looking forward to in the next episode of Island of Junara and kind of what happened in this one. And this one, when we made it to the island across the way there, there were spawners everywhere. And I do mean, just littered along the ground. As you watch, you will see once we get over there that there was probably 8 to 10 creeper spawners that I've broke all, you know, outside those two houses. We found some more gold and bricks and iron. We got a couple more things done on the monument throughout the playthrough, but what I found was interesting is like almost every 5 minutes or so, maybe a little bit longer, I'm dying. And it's not because of, you know, a mob. Well, there is one or two in there, because I'm just straight walking off the path. I'm not even paying attention. I'm so engaged with talking with him throughout the gameplay that I completely forget that, you know, I'm on this one block pathway to get where I need to go. It was awful. It really was. I mean, in the end, I got tired of dying so much, and that's why I cut it. It's a little bit longer of an episode. I believe this one reached somewhere around 25 minutes or so after all the editing and stuff like that. Otherwise, I mean, we really are thinking about going out one direction. Like, we kind of have behind the monument, but I want to completely change it on the next episode because we dropped down on one that's kind of nearby, and that's where we stopped. I'm thinking about we'll go back up and we'll start a whole other direction. But the reason why I wanted to do this behind the mic kind of thing, that we kind of see where all this creativity comes from, is I want input from you. Is there an island that you know about that you should want us to visit? Maybe there's something on there that we don't know about that's hidden, or, you know, out of the way that we haven't really discovered yet. And on another hand, I know there's a whole bunch of adventure maps out there. Is there an adventure map that you've played that you thought was really, really fun to play, and you would like to see me and him try our hand at it, do it our way, see if we can do as good as you? Which I seriously doubt, because I've seen so many people do Islands of Junara, and they're way better at surviving than me and him. It seems like, well, me, I should say. Shut up. I don't want to hear it, I did. Don't even go there. But it seems like I can't keep myself alive long enough, because we've probably lost, I'll say, somewhere between 2 or 3 gold blocks, around 4 or 5 iron blocks. Emeralds we've actually kept on, hang on to. That's one thing that we found during this gameplay that was really hard to find. You know, at first we weren't really looking for the emerald because we had kind of found them in the first couple of episodes there. But with this one, we found some, but it's getting to the point that I think that the hardest blocks for me and him to find in this whole playthrough that we're deciding to do is going to be diamonds and emeralds, because every time we're finding one of the two, it's only like 4 or 5 or 1 or 2 of each. And then genius over there, I did, yeah, that guy right there, as he's, I'm back at the island from dying again, you know, I'm going through inventory trying to build stuff, and there's creepers and skeletons right there on the monument. Well, he decides to come around the corner being the hero that he is and blows up like a portion of the monument. I'm just like, oh my god. So now there's like the first, I say like 5 or 6 blocks. We may have to go back and look and see exactly what blocks were supposed to go there, because those signs are completely gone. Done. It didn't blow up the wall. It didn't blow, I mean, it blew up the blocks that we had already placed, but it didn't destroy them, thankfully. That way we didn't have to start all over with the gold again, because we're getting to the point now, you'll see in this video, that we get plenty of gold blocks set down. I think we actually get to the point where we only like 2 or 3 more gold blocks, and the gold blocks are finished. The gold seems to be plentiful off the start of the island that, that we started on. So I don't know if we'll ever make it back to Luigi's mansion, blah blah blah. It's just so overwhelmed with mobs. I think that is something that we'll touch on maybe in the future after we get out the when we're in this gameplay. I was noticing that there's a lava island that's just off to the side this way, and then the mushroom island that was just above us on the cobblestone structure thingy that we were messing with. So I started to make my way up toward the mushroom island, and I die again. What else is new? But otherwise, besides just this gameplay and the next one, I really want to step into my other channel just a little bit, just to kind of inform you, because I haven't really updated you guys on this channel on what exactly is happening over there. What I've decided to do is, kind of make this one more of the gaming gameplay channel and make the other one the vlog channel, because that seems to be a little bit more views on the vlogs over there and more views on the games over here. So by separating these, I'm able to take my time and produce better content for you guys, which for me is great, because I don't have to be pressured about pumping out two gameplays that are pretty much the same, just rendered different, edited a little bit different on each channel. I want to bring the fresh, fun, exciting adventures, whatever we decide to do, gameplays here, and then do the whole serious vlogs, news and stuff over there. Otherwise, I'm going to continue on doing the Fear 3 gameplay. So if you're missing out on that, that is something you definitely need to stop, go back and watch, because I've already kind of started the Fear 3. The first video is about what's happening around my town, which is still going on now, which is the good old Fun Fest. It's a yearly thing that comes around. You have to go check out the video to see what it's all about. Otherwise, I have to say that I think the reason I have slowed down posting a lot of the Junara gameplays is because iDead is very, very busy. I would really appreciate it if you went to his channel. I'll link it down below in that little comment box down there, and go check him out, because he is pumping out some really great tutorials, and he's actually playing a game, Among the Sleep, right about now, which is more of a jump scare horror game. I watched a little bit of it, and his newest episode that he just posted not too long ago was absolutely hilarious, because let's just say he loses his mouth for a minute or two. When he said he's truly scared by the game, I think the man was telling the truth, and he was truly, genuinely scared at the jump scares of the video. I'm sorry, man, I can't help but laugh at that. You just gotta go see it, guys. It is the funniest thing. It's some of the best comedy that he's probably done in a long time. Other than that, on other games is we went and bought, a couple of games that I might be bringing to you soon, but I'm not for sure on what you want to see. Are you enjoying the content that I'm posting, being mostly Minecraft, a little bit of a random game with Fear 3, I got some other games that we can play, like Garry's Mod, there's Prop Hunt, there's Trouble in Terrorist Town, and all the different game modes there. I'm thinking about maybe doing like podcast type of show. It's just in the works. It's just something I'm thinking about. Instead of doing the single vlog for the other channel, is do a podcast type of show to where we can do it once a week, gather the news from the week before, catch you up. My God, I'm just blah 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 today. Catch you up on what's happened in our area over the week, and I figured if I can talk iDad or Shaden into doing this type of thing, that it could really change the way my vlog channel runs. For example, knowing what's happening here and then knowing what's happening across the world or in a whole nother state or something could be really interesting, because here you always got the crazy news that the wife brings up usually throughout the day to be like, "Hey, this is a great vlog for you to do. Check this out." Like the whole Lazy River thing that I covered in the first Fear 3 gameplay. Go check it out. It's near the end. You'll see what I'm talking about. Just one of those things that I'm looking forward to really, really growing this channel. And what's horrible is I really wished that I had a got to the point to where I could really record that gameplay. Bam! Confuse you a little bit? You heard the phone ring. Anyways, 'cause when we've done that gameplay, we really did have some fun. We had some hilarious jokes in there that were just kind of posted along the way, and that's what really upset me, is I spent so much time on editing and rearranging and speeding up and just missing that audio might take the fun out of this whole gameplay. I really don't know, so that's why I wanted to come face to face with you. I hardly ever do this type of thing over my gameplay, but gotta try something new every day. I really didn't know what else to do but to just apologize and try to give you more informative and what to look for and what we're doing kind of thing. So to get back on my idea earlier, what do you all think about a podcast? Having random people on there, if you're a subscriber, you can be on there as long as you have a decent mic and you have headsets. I don't want any, echoes coming out of when we're doing this kind of thing. And just kind of throw our own little laughs and jokes and things like that together and have a little bit of fun with it. Post it once a week, see what happens. If it don't work out, we can always go back to the original, or maybe there'll be, and I'll come up with a whole new idea, a whole new strategy of growing that channel for what I want it to be, and growing this channel for what I want it to be. Another thing that I brought up in the Fear 3, if you missed it, is being accompanied with two different partners. I'm going to be really working hard on doing a vlog and showing you the inside world of both companies. I know I'm not supposed to do that type of thing, but I'm going to do it that way. You'll have a better understanding and understand how to make a more intelligent decision on what you want to do if you choose full screen freedom. I want to give you the inside look. I'll show you my pages. Of course, still have to be some things that I'll blur out, blah blah blah, stuff like that. But I'll give you the insight on who's got this, who's got that, what they do kind of thing. And I think that'll really help out the smaller channels that are just getting started to get a general idea of who would they want to be with, which is easier, which is better, which is more, accessible for other people to watch, things like that. But to be on the real with you, YouTube's a lot harder than a lot of Minecraft players, a lot of big YouTubers, a lot of gamers, dare I say, make it out to be. Because it takes a lot of your time to be able to edit and cut together and add music, add this scene. That's the biggest part. And then becoming entertaining on top of that acting, dare I say, is probably the hardest part of YouTube, is keeping your mind constantly rolling, keeping your mouth constantly moving, keeping it, whatever it is, relative, entertaining, and capturing is probably the hardest part of YouTube. I'll definitely have to say that for the bigger guys that do like the streams and all that stuff, they've got skill. So if you're looking into doing this kind of thing, it will be something I'll cover in full from beginning to end in a near episode here soon. It won't be quite yet, but here in the next week or so, I will cover it on my vlog channel. I'll share it to this channel. I'll share it all over the place. It's something that you're going to need to see. That way, you get a gist on how to make yourself better. I know for me, that's not necessarily a good thing because look at this webcam. It's all. Let me wipe that off. It's all grainy, but it's what I got. I'm hoping that this entertainment from here is compensating for that dull, dreary, just faded look on the webcam, but it's what I deal with every day. Sometimes you gotta jump over the hurdles or just go around them completely and just move on, move forward, get it over with. And just not even worry about it, just make sure that your gameplays are the best content you can have. Otherwise, that's pretty much everything that I wanted to cover while this gameplay was going on. Odd. I know. Trust me, I get it. But this was my only option. You can blame I did for that. You know what the worst part of the whole thing was? Is he got a phone call. Right when we started, there was literally anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes of him being on the phone. Yeah, that's right. I'm putting you on blast. And what it was is he's kind of building like a Zen garden, and he was crafting in real life, as he called it. And that's why I decided, you know what, instead of cutting up all the audio, taking all that time, I just bring you my face. And just kind of catch you up with what's going around in my world. So I thank you guys for watching. Thank you for understanding on the change of what I had to do with this episode. And I kind of hope you like this behind the mic, real life, real talk situations. And really let me know about that podcast. See y'all next time.